हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई डॉक्टर चीनू अग्रवाल, अ साइकोलॉजिस्ट, डायरेक्टर ऑफ फीलिंग माइंड्स एंड द ट्रस्टी ऑफ हेमा फाउंडेशन विल डिस्कस टुडे इन डिटेल अबाउट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वैल्यू इन लाइफ. साहस मीन्स करेज. फ्रेंड्स, सिंस आवर चाइल्डहुड, रानी लक्ष्मीबाई एंड छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज आर द ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटीज हूज स्टोरीज ऑफ करेज हैव बीन नरेटेड टू अस. एंड देयर स्टोरीज inspired each one of us because we have heard how they fought various obstacles in life with sheer courage and strength till their last breath. So friends, does that mean that we always need to win a war to show that we are courageous? It is not like that. In reality, we have to demonstrate courage each day and each moment to live the life we always wished for ourselves. Just think about it. Saying sorry for our mistakes is not that easy, right? Standing up for friends, especially when they are right, or even to say the truth, requires a lot of courage. During COVID-19, when we were scared and vulnerable, we preferred to stay at our homes. At that time, we bounced back and continued with our busy lives like we did during the pre-pandemic phase. Friends, courage is actually a perception. To be courageous or brave does not mean that we don't get scared at all or there is absence of fear. Being courageous actually means that in spite of the obstacles we face in life, we have the capability of not giving up easily. Courage is a well-thought decision that is taken by each one of us. When we experience fear, even at that time, when we decide to stay determined and strong, it is called as being courageous or strong. There are several ways of nurturing the value of courage amongst kids. Sometimes we tend to get scared of very little things in life. Those things could definitely be little or small for others, but for some of us, it could be a major reason of fear. Research by psychologists state that out of every 4 kids, at least one kid would be experiencing stage fear or is scared to come on stage. This is also called as social anxiety. So what do we do in such situations? We could actually take small consistent steps towards gradually developing courage and strength within each one of us. We can definitely make an attempt to learn something new or different, which we have been postponing since long. So friends, for example, if you do not know how to swim, then you can surely make an attempt to learn how to swim. Instead of directly going on stage to address the audience, you could first learn how to hold the mic in the correct way. Then you could learn how to say your name on stage, and then you will realize that you have become so much more confident that you would easily speak over a period of time. Whatever task or job we take up has an outcome which is always predetermined. It cannot happen that you complete a task and you won't get the result out of it. Please prepare yourself to accept the outcome of anything you wish to do in different stages of life so that we are not scared by their outcomes. Even our family and friends could be a great pillar of support to nurture courage and strength within us. We should definitely take out some time. And all the tasks we have completed in our daily lives which needed courage, especially the little ones, should be discussed with them. This will surely motivate us. At the end of the day, before we hit the bed, we should reflect that did I hurt anyone intentionally or unintentionally due to some reason today? Decide to be extremely determined and strong that today I will surely gather the courage to say sorry to him. The word sorry will help you to enhance all your relationships by making them stronger, which will make a huge difference. Friends, we are often told that we should always say the truth. But is it truly possible? That too without being courageous? Many a times in life, we feel that lying is much easier. But if we make ourselves a little stronger, could we gradually start practicing the art of saying the truth? Every courageous act of us should be goal-oriented or focused on the purpose. Start discussing it with your friends that which of our behaviors could be classified under being playful and which of the behaviors clearly indicate that we could be scared or nervous. Many a times, our friends ask or request us to do certain things or tasks, and when we refuse to do them, they say, "Hey, you don't have the courage to do it." It is better to clearly classify these behaviors and mannerisms for your betterment. Courage does not mean the absence of fear at all. Friends, we all have some role models in our lives who truly inspire us, who also motivate and encourage each one of us as they are very courageous. Do talk about these role models with your friends and family and share your views, so that not only would you be encouraged by doing this, but even your friends and family would be inspired. In addition, there is another important thing. Friends, in life, it is very natural that in some situations, we would be scared or nervous. We could even give up sometimes. In such situations, negative thoughts surround us from all sides. At that time, our confidence tends to get low or shattered, and we tend to get hesitant to do any new task or job even in future. This should not happen with us. That is why we should accept the fact that it is natural to feel scared, nervous, or even low on confidence. And to counter these feelings, always stay calm and say positive affirmations. Please say, "It is okay that I didn't get through this time. I will try once more." And trust me, you will notice that you have the required courage to overcome the big obstacles in life. Friends, courage is gathered when you make an attempt. So please take the first step. Thank you.